Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Chemistry Basics. Today we are going to see multiple choice questions on rearrangement reactions. Okay, so let's go directly to the first question. The rearrangement reactions includes modification in carbon skeleton, modification in functional group, movement of substituents from one position to another, or all of these. So in rearrangement reaction, all these steps are going to happen. Modification in carbon skeleton, modification in functional group, movement of substituent. So answer D will be the correct answer. Next, Wagner-Meyerwin rearrangement involves option A, classical carbocation, option B, non-classical carbocation, or C, nitrene, D, carbene. So are you getting the answer? So let's see what's the Wagner-Meyerwin rearrangement. So this is the Wagner-Meyerwin rearrangement in which non-boron systems generally used. So this will lead to the formation of this non-classical carbocation. So the option B will be the correct answer. Beckmann rearrangement is a type of dash dash rearrangement. 1-2 rearrangement, 1-3 rearrangement, 1-4 rearrangement, or 1-5 rearrangement. Let's see the Beckmann rearrangement first. So this is the Beckmann rearrangement in which oximes generally converted into a N-substituted amide, and that oximes are formed from the ketones. Okay, so if you see here in this particular Beckmann rearrangement, this alkyl group, that R group, is migrated from 1 to 2 positions, so from carbon to nitrogen. So with respect to these two, this alkyl group will migrate from one position to two position, and therefore it is known as a 1-2 rearrangement. So answer A is the correct. Now next, the rearrangement involves exchange of alkylidine fragment known as alkylidine fragments. So generally carbon-carbon double bond. So that are going to be exchanges. So what will be that particular reaction? So it is a pericyclic reaction, olefin metathesis, 1-2 rearrangement, or Hofmann rearrangement. So let's see first that reaction. Here it is. So these are the vinyl compound generally having the double bonds, and now here this particular alkylidine fragments are going to be exchanged. See this particular alkylidine fragment and this alkylidine fragment, they will come closer to each other and ethylene group will be eliminated. So exchange of alkylidine fragments takes place here, and such a type of reactions are known as olefin metathesis. So option B is the correct answer. The rearrangement involves formation of cyclopropanone intermediate is. So this is very important, cyclopropanone, and it is the very well known reaction. That's the, let's see what's that cyclopropanone intermediate first. See here it is alpha haloketone or 2-chlorocyclohexanone we are taking here, and in this particular reaction if you see the intermediate cyclopropanone is formed. So which is this, the famous reaction? It's a Favreschi rearrangement. So option B is the correct. Which of the following rearrangement do involve nitrene intermediate or nitrene species? So option A, Beckmann, B, Lawson, C, Baer-Villiger, D, pinacol-pinacolone rearrangement. So what will be the answer? So rearrangements generally involves nitrene species are Hofmann, Curtius, Schmitz, and Lawson. So therefore the answer B will be the correct answer. Question number 7, the reagent can be used to form nitrene intermediate. Now we have to use the reagent that can form the nitrene intermediate. So option A, sodamide, second soda azide, sulfuric acid, or thalamide. So the reagents which gives you the nitrene species are, see, it's nitrous acid, sodium hypobromide, soda azide, or hydrozoic acid. So these are the reagents which will give you the nitrene species. So out of these four, which will be in the options, it's a soda azide. So option B will be the correct. Rearrangement which do not involve formation of nitrene intermediate. So just we have seen that which reactions are there that involves the nitrene intermediate, which are that reactions. So Hofmann, Curtius, Schmitz and Lawson. So rearrangement which do not involve formation of nitrene intermediate. So Hofmann involved, Curtius involved, Schmitz also involved, but Favorsky not involved the nitrene species. Favorsky involves the cyclopropanone intermediate. So remember that. So option D will be the correct answer. The rearrangement in which acyl chloride is converted into primary amine is. So acyl chloride should be converted into primary amine. So A. Hofmann, B. Curtius, C. Schmitz and D. Beckmann. So what will be the answer? So let's see the first reaction. Here it is. So acyl chloride first will be converted into nitrene. So this involves the nitrene species. So definitely answer will be in A, B, C and not in the, not will be the D answer. Okay. And then acyl nitrene to amine will be there. Just hydrolysis of isocyanate takes place. So such type of reaction or this reaction is a very well known reaction. That's the Curtius reaction. So which includes acid chlorides generally. Okay. The following conversion can be achieved by which rearrangement? Cyclohexanone oxime to epsilon caprolactam. So we have to prepare the epsilon caprolactam. So this can be observed. Epsilon caprolactam is a amide. Okay, so it's a cyclic amide. So amides are generally the product of which reaction? Which reaction? Beckmann reaction. Okay. So here it is, cyclohexanone can be converted into oxime and oxime then can be converted into epsilon caprolactam by the Beckmann reaction and hence the answer will be D, that's the Beckmann. In Beckmann rearrangement, the group to dash dash to hydroxyl group is migrated to nitrogen. So now a stereochemical aspect. So in Beckmann rearrangement, the group dash dash to OH group is migrated to nitrogen, whether it is syn to OH, whether it is anti to OH or both can migrate, that syn and anti or none of these. So just see the Beckmann reaction. If you see the migration of this alkyl group, R group, so it is exactly opposite, that is anti to this OH group. So here is the OH, it is converted into OH2 plus, it's a good leaving group. So R group is migrated exactly opposite to that, that is the anti position and hence answer will be anti. Ketones can be converted to esters by using peroxy acids in dash dash rearrangement. So ketones are converted into esters. So very important reaction again. So let's see that. Here it is. So these ketones can be converted into esters by using peroxy acids and the well known rearrangement is known as Baer-Villiger rearrangement. The alpha haloketones are converted into acid by which rearrangement? So Favorsky, Claisen, Baer-Villiger or Wagner-Meyerwin rearrangement. So here it is given that alpha haloketone is converted into carboxylic acid. See, alpha haloketones are converted into carboxylic acid, but which is the reaction? Okay. So here it is, this reaction, alpha haloketone is converted into a carboxylic acid here and it's a well-known reaction, it's a Favorsky. Next question, benzophenone is converted to phenylbenzoate by using dash dash reagent. So we have to again convert ketone to ester. So see here, this is the ketone and this is the ester. So again we have to use the Baer-Villiger rearrangement, and in Baer-Villiger rearrangement, per acids or peroxy acids are generally used. So here it's given there per benzoic acid, soda azide, dilute KMnO4 or SOCl2. So per benzoic acid is used for this particular reaction. Some other reagents are also given there, so that can do that conversion. So it's a MCPBA, so that's the metachloroperbenzoic acid, peracetic acid, peroxy trifluoroacetic acid. These are also doing the same job. So answer will be A. Pinacol-pinacolone rearrangement is option A intramolecular, option B intermolecular, C non-regioselective or D all of these. So here it is, pinacol-pinacolone rearrangement. So if you see here, The migration of methyl group from this position takes place on the carbon, which is the part of same molecule. So definitely we can say this reaction is an intramolecular reaction. So migration takes place within the same molecule, and therefore answer will be intramolecular. The most powerful migratory aptitude is found in pinacol-pinacolone rearrangement for whether it is aryl, then tertiary alkyl, secondary alkyl or primary. Out of that four, which is having the highest migratory aptitude? So this is the order. So aryl groups are generally having higher migratory aptitude as they are going to be stabilizing that carbocation again. Okay, so aryl will be the correct answer. The reaction of benzene with N-propyl chloride with anhydrous AlCl3 gives major product which? So whether it is A thiamine, B cumene, N propyl benzene or toluene. So it is a simple Hilcroft's alkylation reaction, and if you see your N propyl bromide when reacted with the benzene, so it will give you major product cumene. N propyl benzene is in very poor yield, in fact it will not form. So major product will be cumene. So answer B. Isocyanate on hydrolysis with water form dash dash. Whether it is acid, B amide, C ester or D amine. So let's see what happens when isocyanates undergo hydrolysis. So here it is the reaction. Hydrolysis reaction with the water. So this isocyanate first gives the carbamic acid, and which further on removal of this particular CO2, the decarboxylation takes place and you are getting the amine here. So option D will be the correct answer. Ketones on condensation with hydroxyl amine forms, whether it is oxide, oxime, hydroxide or oxirane. So let's see the reaction, what will happen when ketones on reaction with hydroxyl amine. So see here it is. So this is the benzophenone. So I am taking one example of the ketone, and we are reacting with the hydroxyl amine, so it will form the oxime as a product. So remember that it's a very important reaction. So option B will be the correct reaction. It is the just initial reaction of that Beckmann rearrangement, because in Beckmann rearrangement starting material is a oxime. Okay, so option B will be the correct. Claisen rearrangement is dash dash type of reaction, whether it is a 3 to sigma tropic, 1 to sigma tropic, 2 to sigma tropic or 3-3 sigma tropic rearrangement. So all we know that Claisen rearrangement. So here it is Claisen rearrangement. If you see here, so if you are giving the numbers like this 1 to 3, 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 3 dash. So bond here 3 dash bond is breaking and 1 dash bond is formed. So as here 3 carbon fragment and here also 3 carbon fragment is involved, and the reaction will take place here. So therefore such a type of reactions are known as a 3-3 sigma tropic rearrangement reaction. So option D will be the correct answer. Claisen rearrangement is an example of dash dash reaction, whether it is 1-2 rearrangement, olefin metathesis, pericyclic reaction or none of these. So 1-2 rearrangement already we have seen that Beckmann rearrangement is there, and Claisen rearrangement in previous slide we have seen that there is no such a type of 1-2 rearrangements. Okay, let's see the Claisen rearrangement again. So if you see here, so this Claisen rearrangement generally involves the heat, so it will be a pericyclic reaction. The simplest precursor of oxac cations, oxygen is having the positive charge, so electrophilic oxygen we require. So whether it is per acid, per oxide, formic acid or both A and B. So generally per acids or peroxides or peroxy linkages are generally electrophilic. So the simplest precursor of oxac cation is per acid as well as per oxide. So option D will be the correct answer. Now nitrene is, whether it is positively charged, negatively charged, no formal charge or free radical. So nitrene species, it's a very much electron deficient species, but it do not have any charge. So nitrene having no formal charge. Okay, this is about the nitrene. Here we have shown it's acyl nitrene. So nitrene do not having any charge here. So option C will be the correct. The cyclohexanone can be converted to lactone by using which enzyme? So again, it is one of the very important reaction that the ketone is converted into a ester. Lactone is the cyclic ester. So it's a Bayer-Villiger reaction, and for that, which type of enzymes can be used? So here it is given cyclohexanone oxygenase, cyclohexanone deoxygenase, zymase, or cyclohexanone hydrogenase. So which will be the enzyme used for this? So here is the reaction. Cyclohexanone is converted into lactone by using cyclohexanone oxygenase. So we have to add the oxygen. So definitely oxygenase we have to use. Don't use deoxygenase. Okay. So option A will be the correct. The vicinal diols can be converted into ketones or aldehydes by dash dash rearrangement. So vicinal diols will be converted into ketones. Again, one of the familiar rearrangement, whether it is Hopman, Pinakol, Favreski or Pomerski reactions. Here is the reaction. So vicinal diols are converted into ketone, and it is a OL to ONE. So here it is OL, it is converted into ONE. So definitely it's a pinacol-pinacolon rearrangement. So option B will be the element is dash dash reaction. A reversible, B irreversible, C intramolecular, and D none of these. So remember this, pinacol-pinacolon rearrangement is a reversible reaction. In Bayer-Villiger reaction, migration of group mostly proceed with whether it is retention of configuration, inversion of configuration, racemization, or all of these. So if that R group is a chiral, then whether it will be proceed with the retention of configuration or inversion of configuration or racemization. So it will proceed with mostly retention of configuration there. Pinacol-pinacolon rearrangement is catalyzed by acid only. So we have seen that reaction, that acid is used there in pinacol-pinacolon reaction. So whether it is true or false, it's a false. Why it is false? Because pinacol-pinacolon rearrangement can be catalyzed by photochemically also, H-nuc photochemical, and therefore it's a false. In Favreski reaction, cyclic alpha haloketone is proceed with dash dash. If we are taking the cyclic alpha haloketone in Favreski reaction, what will be the product? So whether it will be the ring expansion, whether it will be the ring contraction, whether it ring opening reaction, or all of these. So usually Favreski reaction of cyclic alpha haloketones proceed with, see here it's a 6-membered ring and here it's a 5-membered ring. So it's a ring contraction. Okay. In Favreski reaction, if amine is used as a base, then product will be. So what will be, whether it is ester, amide, amine or ether. So in Favreski reaction, product is depends on base also. So if you are using the NaOH there, so you are getting the carboxylic acid. If you are using the alkoxide ions, you will get the esters. If you are using the amines, then you will get the amides. Okay. So in Favreski reaction, if amines are used, product will be amide. Now again question is on Favreski. So Favreski rearrangement of alpha dash dihaloketone with alkoxide ion produces dash dash product. Whether it is alpha beta unsaturated ester, there is alpha beta unsaturated amide, a ring compound, or a beta gamma unsaturated ester. So here we are using the alkoxide. So definitely in Favreski reaction, when we are using the alkoxide, product will be ester. So answer will be either A or D. So when you are using that, so definitely you will get alpha beta unsaturated esters, because there will be the removal of hydrohalogenation. Okay, so dehydrohalogenation reaction will take place there, and you are getting alpha beta unsaturated ester compound. Claisen rearrangement follows dash dash order kinetics. So whether it is first order, second order, third order, or zero order. So Claisen rearrangement follows first order kinetics. So remember this. So thank you very much for watching this video. So if you like this, subscribe the channel. You can press the bell icon button so you will get the notification of my next video. So that's the important thing. You can share this video, and if you have any questions, you can comment in comment section. So thank you very much. So thank you very much.